Hey guys, Joshua Bainsick, and I've got a Cruiser-like case for you today. It's for the OnePlus One. This is the Circuit Droid Edition, and I got it in black this time. If you've seen my reviews in the past, I've pretty much got a Cruiser-like case for every device that I've ever owned, and I pretty much stick with that green color, which I still love, and I actually have it on my Note 3 at the moment. I went with black because I'm going to be working outdoors in a lawn care landscaping type of business, so I don't want the case to look dirty, so the black is definitely the best choice for me at this point in time. I have been using the Pelosi black sandstone case that I ordered off of AliExpress, and main reason is because it has a similar texture to what the OnePlus One has already, and I really do enjoy that texture a lot. But with the industry that I'm fixing to go into for work, I need something more protective, and that's why I got the Cruiser Light case. Now, one of the main reasons why I chose to go with Cruiser Light for a protective case is because it literally is, from what I have researched, the most protective case that you can get for the OnePlus One. There was one case I did see on eBay that was an aluminum bumper with an aluminum plate on the back, but I wasn't really too fond of that idea for a few different reasons, because of the metal possibly interfering with the signal. And then honestly, it just did not look that great. Now, I've really enjoyed Cruiser-like cases in the past, and it's always been my go-to case, so I'm just going to stick with Cruiser-like. So just kind of taking a look around the case, you do notice the Circuit Droid kind of design that they have, and it's on the outside of the case as well as the inside. And as you can see from the glares from the light, there's a glossy finish that kind of outlines the design, and the rest of it is like a matte kind of finish. If you're not familiar with Cruiser-like cases, these are made from TPU, and TPU is really actually durable material. It's going to be able to withstand some good drops, and it'll protect against those bumps and scrapes. It's really easy installation. I just like to start at the bottom, line up the charging port, come on over to the top, and just fold over the edges. The case is raised above the screen, so if you want to put it face down on a flat, smooth surface, you'll be fine, and it'll be protected. One of the first things I noticed about this case was that there's a slight difference from what we've seen in the past, and it's because it has actual button covers versus cutouts for the volume and the power button. The reason why I believe this is because I did actually see some complaints about how the cutouts were too deep for accessing the power button, so it looks like they fixed that problem, and it's actually a nice fix. It's relatively easy to press the button, it's not that much effort at all, and I do like how they made that adjustment just to help make sure that you can still use the phone without it being a pain in the butt. The OnePlus One, they have small buttons, so I do see why that could have been a complaint. If the cutout was too deep, it might have been too hard to access. One of the main reasons why I got this case for protective reasons is because all the edges are protected. Now, I do love that sandstone black Pelosi case, but the top and bottom are exposed, and that kind of made me nervous being able to use it in the kind of industry that I'm fixing to go into. With the Cruiser Light case, I don't have that kind of worry, and this is black, and I don't have to really worry about it getting dirty either. As far as grip goes, it feels good in the hand, it doesn't feel slippery, but it's got a smooth kind of surface, so if you want to put it in and out of your pocket, it's going to be really easy to use. Now here in the back, you do have a precise cutout for your cameras and also your microphone. Down at the bottom, we have precise cutouts for your speaker and your USB connection. Up at the top, along with the other cutouts, really precise for the headphone jack and also the other microphone. The sides, they kind of bend, but it's flexible material, but it's not too bad. You actually have to kind of put some force behind it for it to bend, so it's really good design. I do enjoy Cruiser-like cases a lot, and that's why, again, I went with this company. They've been a good support of Bentec for one, but also I just enjoy their products. Now personally, I would like to see the Experience case make it over to the OnePlus One, because it does have the stock Android kind of design and feel to the phone itself, and it would match the Experience case kind of purpose for that design as well. So I think that this case is a really good option for you if you're a OnePlus One owner and you're looking for something that has good protection. I promise I've done my research, I've dug everywhere to try to find a rugged style case, and there's just not one out there. The Cruiser Light case is the toughest case you can pretty much get for the OnePlus One at this point. Let's hope that changes in the near future, because I still want a rugged case just for those situations to where I need one. But this Cruiser Light case is definitely going to get me by, and I feel confident it's going to give me protection throughout the day. If you'd like to pick one up for yourself, I'll leave a link in the description. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed yet, please do so you can see more videos like this.